It's really a function of, as the border situation has changed in this country, and that changed dramatically about 4 years ago, where we saw a sudden rise in the percentage of people who are families and with minor children and unaccompanied minors. We didn't in the U.S. pivot our detention apparatus. We continue to apply this approach, so where we utilize facilities that were designed for adults to be held for no more than 24 hours, and now we have children in those. I think the other thing is we continue to spend our resources focused on this kind of security-based approach rather than recognizing the humanitarian nature of this crisis and funding those agencies that are in charge of processing these people through quickly. So what you get as a result is longer-term detention in facilities that are inadequate, and then the basics start to slip, like toothbrushes and blankets and basic essentials.
Yeah, I'm curious, what did you make of that video that's making the rounds of that government attorney having to argue as to what should qualify as a basic level of care?
Well, as an attorney, I mean, listen, that's an appalling argument to make, and it's an appalling argument for a government attorney to make. I have some sympathy for the attorney herself, but the reality is that these are the kind of things that the U.S. government cannot and should not be arguing. We owe a basic duty of care to these individuals. And you may disagree with the fact that they're coming. You may want to see them moved out of the country. You may not want to see there to be any any immigration to the United States whatsoever. But I think everybody can agree that there's a basic duty of care afforded to them that includes toothbrushes, soap, and basic hygiene. Look, we have to pivot our approach and recognize we have a different problem at the border today than we did just 5 years ago. 5 years ago, we were trying, the difficulties was in identifying adult males who would, entered the United States unlawfully and would attempt to evade capture. Today, we have a massive humanitarian crisis where you have large numbers of families and children who are walking across the border and surrendering to the first Border Patrol agent they see. Rather than use this deterrent-based approach that relies on detention, we need to shift resources to recognize that this population doesn't need to be detained. Instead, what we need to do is process their cases quickly. That is no less soft in terms of border security. It can mean individuals, large numbers of individuals, being removed from the United States. But what we can avoid in that process is this system where we have now these children being held in these facilities that were never designed for even adults to be detained this long. So there was a recent study that came out, represented by an attorney, something like 99% show up. In my experience, the majority of these people want to show up. They believe they're eligible for asylum in the United States and want an opportunity to present that claim. There a lot of times, though, unfortunately, in the chaos that we're seeing, where basically toothbrushes aren't even provided, people are not getting adequate notice of their hearings, or the government gets the address wrong, and then when they actually have their court date, they just don't show up because they weren't aware. I would venture a guess that the majority of the people have failed to appear. The majority of them just didn't know that the hearing was ongoing. But the reality is that even if you look at the broader number, it's a very high percentage. The overwhelming majority of people do show up for the hearings, and that's especially true if they have counsel. It's a function of a couple of things. One is we've never adequately, as the situation at the border shifted to where you have all these unaccompanied minors and families with kids, we didn't adequately fund the resources, the officers at USCIS and Health and Human Services, who process these cases quickly. So now they're stuck in CBP custody for longer. Secondly, we haven't built, adequate facilities to process these individuals, and we're trying to, implement this deterrence-based approach that relies on detention, which increases the length of time that they're being detained. And so it's a recipe for disaster. All of the horrible things we've heard about, over the last 6 months to a year, are all quite predictable. Young people dying in CBP custody, failure to provide adequate hygiene. There really is no way to detain this population that's safe and humane. But if you look at it from a security perspective, as someone who looks at it from a border security perspective, we don't need to detain this population. We need to process them. We need to adjudicate their asylum claims quickly. We need to make sure that there's no secret criminal history here or something of that nature, that they don't pose a threat to the United States. But the overwhelming majority of these people pose neither a flight risk nor a public safety threat to the United States, and we shouldn't be spending billions of dollars detaining them, especially when we're not able to do it in a healthy and humane way.